Where do you see Binance in 1 year time and 3 year time from now?
I hope to see 1 billion users in this industry. I think the key right now is not so much focusing on your own business, it's actually let's just make the pie bigger. Let's just grow the industry. Don't launch a cryptocurrency exchange. It's one of the worst businesses to run.
You launched Binance through a very successful ICO in 2017. What would be a recommendation for a young entrepreneur that wants to launch its own cryptocurrency exchange today?
Okay, my first advice would be don't launch a cryptocurrency exchange. It's one of the worst businesses to run. It's really tough, it's really tricky, there's a lot of different headaches. But if you really want to run one, I would just focus on the users. So just focus on providing extra services that the current exchanges are now able to provide. It's getting increasingly more difficult because right now the exchanges are no longer just exchanges. We actually do a lot more than just exchanges. We're really adding a lot more added services like staking, lending, all this other stuff. So I would say just think about what the unique service offerings are, and we would like to see more creativity around this space, and we want to copy and improve as well.
Okay, cool. But do you think it's more difficult now than when you launched yourself?
Absolutely. I think it's definitely more difficult right now. The exchanges are much more competitive right now than maybe say two or three years ago. Customer service have gotten a lot better. System stability have gotten a lot better. Communication with social media has gotten a lot better. So it's actually quite tough to start one right now. I would say, yeah, it's harder.
This year, you launched Binance in the US after you focused a long time on the Asian market. How is the US market responding and how is it different from the Asian markets?
For Binance US, we actually work with a local partner, BAM Trading Services in the United States. When we first started, we just didn't have the bandwidth to target the United States. It is one of the largest markets in the world. But at the same time, we started in Asia, so we didn't really have the resources to target that market, and there were fairly well established players there. They do provide decent services. So 2 years later, we said, well, other exchanges are leaving the U.S., and we see a clear path of being able to offering our services finally there. And so we found a really good partner. They have a really good team. We felt the time was right, and there's a clear path to properly service U.S. users in a fully compliant way, locally onshore, with U.S. dollar support. So we thought that's a very unique opportunity for us to enter and not to walk away.
Where do you see Binance in 1 year time and 3 year time from now? What are the milestones that you hope to achieve in these time frames?
In 1 year time, we hope to add a lot more fiat support. And so there's 200 countries in the world. We service about 180 of them. And we want to be able to provide fiat supporting all of those countries if possible. I think in a year time, we're probably not going to achieve that. Maybe hopefully we'll add 20, 30, 40 fiat support. I don't really have an exact number in my head. In 3 years time, I hope we can make the industry a lot bigger. I hope to see 1 billion users in this industry. Right now, I think we're probably around 100 million-ish users, depending on how you count. I don't really have a specific target for like number of users for Binance. I think the key right now is not so much focusing on your own business. It's actually, let's just make the pie bigger. Let's just grow the industry.
Okay, and what role do you think Venus, your project related to, similar to Libra, is gonna play in this advancement?
So Libra, for Venus, we're trying to provide a similar but maybe slightly different positioned stable coins. So that we think there will be multiple stable coins throughout different parts of the world that's pegged to fiat and that people can use. And we hope that all of these fiat stable coins are supported by governments or large existing companies. So we launched BUSD as the first one, the Binance USD, and Binance USD is already accepted by the Bermudian government for paying taxes. So that's even though it's a small country, but that's a pretty significant, meaningful milestone. So we're hoping to add maybe, I don't know, 20, 30, 50, 100 stable coins like that. Our approach is a little bit different. We historically have founded, so far we found it much easier to work with smaller countries because the government's simpler, they move faster. Whereas, for example, if you look at Singapore, there's only one regulatory agency you got to deal with, and you talk to them, they make a decision, you're done. Whereas in larger countries, there's probably like 10, 20, 50 different regulatory bodies you have to work with. So they do move a little bit slower given the complex structure. So, but we want to work with everybody in the world to push more stable coins, to have more fiat gateways into the ecosystem.
What should actually happen in the industry? What kind of technological advancement should happen in order to increase adoption?
If you ask me in 2016, what's going to be the next killer app that's going to bring everybody in, I would not have said ICOs or fundraising on blockchain. So those things are really, really difficult to predict. But for us, we're just enabling more fiat access so that people can access crypto more easily. But I think in terms of the industry, there's probably a number of potential things that could tip the scale, but I'm really speculating if I name anything. But I think gaming is pretty big, payments are pretty big, e-commerce, probably a little bit later, but they could be pretty big. Thanks so much. Yeah, thank you so much. Cheers.
Cointelegraph. Like, subscribe, and HODL.